Hi, I'm Chris James, and you're watching A Healthy Alternative. Today, we're going to be discussing the psychology around what you eat.
We're missing a piece of the puzzle.
You start getting healthy, and you just become a better person.
We need to start focusing more on the individual.
Before we start today's video, I wanted to give a shout out to all of those who have purchased my new book, Metamorphosis, A Journey to Holistic Wellness. I wanted to let you all know that I greatly appreciate your support and investment in me and as well as yourself. And I look forward to getting feedback from you all about the book once they finally do ship. We have had some delays due to the COVID situation, but they will be on the way very, very shortly. So thank you for your patience. Anyone interested in purchasing a book can get it from directly from the website, healthyalternative.org. I'll leave a link for that in the description box. So recently I was speaking to a member of the community. I think it was a consultation, but I cannot remember exactly. And we were talking about how we interact with food, the psychology around food, and really how the body is our temple, okay? So for those of you who have followed me for a while, you probably know, you've probably heard me say that we are energetic beings. And if we are energetic beings, our essence is energy. Obviously, our physical bodies aren't exactly us, right? So you pass away, and then your physical body gets left here, your avatar, or whatever you kind of want to refer to it as, and your energetic self or essence continues on its journey wherever that is. So with that being said, our body is a temple that we reside in. And, you know, I've heard it said that our bodies are these billion-dollar vessels. It's really hard to put a price tag on what the body is worth. And we really shouldn't be treating our temples poorly. Okay. And I think I pulled that from Vicky, who we recently had on the show. So anyway, I was talking to this other individual. We were just discussing what you put in your body, right? Now, I've talked many times about how you genuinely are what you eat on a cellular level. What you eat is absorbed into your cells, and you become that thing, whatever it is that you're eating. And it's very important us to be cognizant of that fact. We want to make sure we're putting good living food in our body. But if we're doing the opposite and we're putting death in our body, then we start to become death. We start to deteriorate. And that is very, very true. Now, what is death? Well, it's something that is void of energy or very, very low energy. It's something that is taking away from us and not giving to us. And so it's very easy to eat something that is not good for us because there's so many energetically dead, quote unquote, foods out there. All right. So what is a real food? Well, a real food is going to come from a organic source, firstly. And energetically speaking, the foods that are going to have the highest vibration or, you know, what's going to really give back to us would be your plants. Because when you eat a plant, you may not realize it, especially when you're eating a raw, you know, something raw, it's still alive. Like it still has the essence of life and energy in it. And so it provides us with energy. Okay. So our bodies have the ability to extract energy from what it is that we ingest. So you want to be ingesting high energy foods. Now, this is similar to when I mentioned eating high water content foods. When you look at the human body, we are at least, supposedly we're supposed to be at least 72-75% water on the low side. On the high side, you know, 90 plus. So we want to be eating, you know, in order to hydrate the body and to not dehydrate the body, you want to eat waters that are you want to eat foods that have a higher water content than what we are. So if you're on the lower end, you're 70% water, you want to be eating, you know, watermelon and grapes and things like that. And then you just need to be aware of the fact that if you eat something that's lower on the hydration scale, like 72 or 75, that it may in fact pull water from you. Well, it's the same thing with energy. You know, if you're eating something that has high energy, you're going to gain from it. And if you eat something that has lower energy, it's going to extract energy from you. Now, you know, to make things a little bit easy to digest and understand, it's very simple. High water content foods, high energy foods, living foods, the body uses way less actual energy to move that through your system. So you consider the digestive system, you know, uses such an enormous amount of energy because that's how difficult it is to move food. All right. So if you're eating these high energy foods, it's easy to move it. If you're eating the low energy foods, it's very challenging for your body to move it, which is more strain, stress on your organs and on your overall digestive system. That is the reason why we get clogged up so easy. And you know, having a clogged digestive system or a low functioning digestive system, it's not just about being constipated. Everything is going to be affected by this low functioning system. Everything from, yeah, constipation to brain function, you're going to have issues in every area because the body has to be looked at holistically. You can't look at it like, oh, you know, this one organ or this one system doesn't work efficiently, but that's just, you can't just compartmentalize it and say, oh, that's just this one little area. No, it affects everything because the body is all about harmony. So and if anything is out of harmony, you're going to have issues everywhere. So I just wanted to stress the importance of eating living foods and also creating a balance in your diet or your lifestyle. You know, if you're eating the low vibrational foods and, or, you know, foods that are void of energy, you want to keep that to an absolute minimum. I understand that we're all on a journey. So there's going to be a little bit of this and that, you know, you're going to consume that's not the best for you. I do personally still consume things that aren't the best for me. But as I've said many times, you know, moderation is key here. And, you know, we had a guest on a couple of weeks ago talking about how, you know, moderation is impossible for people who have addictions and things like that. So if you have addictions, then you need to obviously approach this a little bit differently. But for those who can practice moderation, you know, just to give yourself that opportunity to gradually make this shift and change, I certainly do think that it's better than beating yourself up about slipping or making mistakes. It's just important to create balance in your life. Okay. So the body is all about balance. When you look at nature, it's all about balance. There's just as much light as there is dark. It's not that one is better or, you know, worse than the other. It's just really about balance. When you think about positive and negative energy isn't bad. Negative energy just balances out positive energy. We have to shift the way that we, you know, view the world, our reality. You know, I think we've been taught that everything is supposed to be good, great, and perfect all the time. And I think in reality, we would get tired of a world like that. It's if you've ever seen The Matrix, the computer, I think he was talking to Neo at one point. Don't quote me. That movie is so old. I haven't seen it in so long. But basically about how the machines had tried to create a perfect world for the humans to live in, and the humans rejected it. And that's because there wasn't balance. It's not about, you know, a world being perfect or a person being perfect for you, or even necessarily a diet being perfect. It's all about balance. And I think that we should focus on that more than we should focus on trying to lean dramatically one way or the other. Okay. So with that being said, I do want you all to enjoy what you eat, have fun with it. Just be mindful of the effects that it has on your system and be aware when you've gone too far to one side and you need to recenter yourself. And I think that we can continue to grow and learn and expand. And I really, really appreciate all of you in the community. I've got some amazing things in the works that I will be announcing very shortly. one of the things I think I did mention to you already is my brother and I, Steven, we will be starting a coaching program. It's something that you all have been asking for years, probably. And our tentative launch date is going to be for October, mid-October. So be on the lookout. If you're interested in some sort of coaching, this will be the first time that we're actually offering that, you know, outside of my consultations that I do. And it's going to be small group sizes. It's going to be more of a holistic coaching. So we're going to be looking at, you know, many, many aspects of wellness, not just specifically fasting, because I think a lot of the issues that we have with fasting is maintaining and the lifestyle that comes after fasting. So we're going to be addressing all of that stuff so that we can make sure that everyone stays level and balanced and harmonious and continues to see benefit year in and year out. So look forward to that. Once again, if you guys are interested in grabbing a book, check it out on the website, ahealthyalternative.org. I'll have the link in the description box below. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button. If you want to see more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe. And as always, the application of knowledge is power. And I will see you all next time.